Okay, good evening everyone. So let me start sharing the screen once again.
Sir, your voice is very low.
My voice is very low. Now,
sir, our voice is low.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Your voice is low.
Sir, somewhat closer.
Yes, sir.
Can't you hear me clearly?
We can hear now, sir. We can hear now.
Yes, sir. Now we can.
Sir, you told first time as a homework.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir?
Yes.
If you don't mind, can I say a thing?
Yes, tell me.
In class 10th, two of them are in pending list. So you have to accept the request.
Okay, I'll accept. Chalo. See, we are going to start today 5.2 exercise. What is that? 5.2 exercise. Exercise 5.2. All right, getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So, first question is, how would you rewrite Euclid's fifth postulate so that it would be easier to understand? How would you rewrite? How would you rewrite? First, look at this here. First, tell me what exactly the Euclid's fifth postulate says to us.
Sir, it is a straight form. It's interior language.
If a straight line falling on two straight lines made the intersecting angle on the same side of it taken together less than two right angles.
Yes, making two either less than right to right angle triangles. So what I have explained, if two lines are passing through these lines, so interior angles, like let me say A, let me say B, let me say C, let me say this angle is D. So if I ask you where these two lines are going to intersect to each other, then what I am going to say? So wherever, if A plus C is less than or equal to 180 degrees, not less than 180 degrees, less than or equal, not. So, and if, or B plus D is less than 180 degrees. If A plus C is 180 degree, less than 180 degree, or B plus D is less than 180 degree. So then what I'm going to get 180, 180. So what I'm going to get now, less than 180, 180. So wherever I'm getting less than sum of two right angles or less than 180 degrees, that side my two lines are going to be intersect to each other. So let us say example now. Let me say example. So if I give two lines like this, and one line is passing through this. Okay. So let me say this is some 95 degrees. Let me say this is from 65 degrees, and let me say this is some 84 degrees. Let me say this is some 103 degrees. Okay, so look at this now. So if I ask you that which side, so let me say this is A, where. So let me give like this one second. Instead of writing that, let me give like this. So this is my A, this is B, this is C, this is D. So now if I give you that, if A is equal 90 degrees or 98 degrees, and B is equal some 68 degrees, C is equal some 104 degrees, and d is equal to some, let us say some 93 degrees. So which side, see, this is my line 1, this is my line 2, and one line is passing through this line 1 and line 2 is some line. Okay, so which line, so which side the lines are going to intersect each other?
Sir, A and B.
A and B side, sir.
A and B side. Look at this first. What I must check? I need to check A plus B. So if I check A plus B, what I'm going to get here? 98, 68 means how much I'm going to get?
166.
What is C plus D? C plus D means
197.
So which one is lesser than 180 degrees? Now A plus B side. So this side. So this part of the side, this part of the lines, I mean this part of the sides of lines going to be intersect to each other. Getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is what I'm getting here, line 1 and line 2. Understood? Any doubt?
No, sir.
No doubt, sir.
No, sir.
No doubt.
Okay. Chalo, next. So let us write first. Now this is what the, you know, Euclid's theorem 5 says to us. Understood? So let us write now. What is Euclid's fifth? Actually, in technical terms, we'll write. So what is the question? The question is, how would you rewrite Euclid's fifth postulate to so that it would be easier to understand? How can we rewrite?
Sir, I wrote it as I would read in a pair of two lines, if the sum of one pair of interior angle on the same side of the transversal
tell me, can you please come back again?
Yes, sir. In a pair of two lines, if the sum of one pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal is lesser than 180 degrees, then both lines will meet in that direction of the pair of lines.
Yes, look at this here. Great, that is also correct. We'll write like that, fifth postulate. If a straight line passing through two straight lines passing through two straight lines makes the interior angles on the same side of it taken together less than two right angles are less than 180 degrees. You write in bracket less than 180 degrees. In bracket, you write less than 180 degrees like this. Then the two Then the two straight lines which produced indefinitely meet on that side on which the sum of angles is less than 180 degrees. So this is what the Euclid's fifth theorem, Euclid's fifth postulate says to us. You can write in your simple language, simple own words as well. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
You can write in your own words as well. There is no issue. Clear? Chalo. So, what did you understand from this? So, therefore, that is, you write, that is, you write, the Euclid's fifth postulate is about parallel lines. Is about what? Parallel lines. About parallel lines. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is parallel line? Sir. What is parallel lines? Parallel lines means, you write one more point, you write. This entire thing is answer only, okay? Parallel lines are the lines which do not intersect each other ever and
sir, can you show above once?
Yes, one second. Always at a constant constant perpendicular distance apart from each other. Once again, parallel lines. Because it's parallel lines, one more point. Parallel lines would be two or more than two lines. Understood, guys? Simple.
Yes, sir.
You can write it over. You see, everything is simple only.
Sir, the last point is saying not only 2 points, more than also we can draw as parallel lines.
Yes.
Okay. So, can you show above?
Make it fast.
Written, sir.
Okay, next. Look, everyone copy this. Chalo, done?
Yes, sir.
Sir, so just 1 second, can you show the output?
Yeah.
Done, sir.
Okay. How can we write still here? What can we write? So next question, shall we go for the next question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Look at the fifth question. Does the Euclid's fifth postulate imply the existence of parallel lines?
Sir, what is the meaning of imply?
Sorry? Imply.
Yes.
Existence means present.
Yes, sir.
Imply means no. Yes. Make it fast. Can anyone of you? Anyone of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, it also implies the existence of all parallel lines as the sum of interior angles of a parallel line in the same direction of transversal is equal to 180 degrees. Then the lines are parallel. If it is lesser than 180 degrees, then they are not parallel and are bound to intersect at a point when extended.
Okay. Look at this. Good explanation. But you know, how theoretically can we write anyone of you?
Sir, can I?
See, he is asking in the first question, you can write this entire part. Or, see, I wrote this entire stuff, but no need of writing this much stuff. So you can write simply, I'll give. Or, this answer one and answer two. Look at this here. This is answer one. Or method one, you say. What is method to rewrite this? So if you ask for 3 marks or 4 marks, you can write that one. But if you ask for 2 marks like this, method two also I'm telling you. Simply. How can we rewrite that? Look at this. Very simple. See, we also can write and write Euclid's fifth postulate as two distinct, very important, two distinct intersecting lines cannot be cannot be parallel to the same line, cannot be parallel to the same line. So this is also correct. Make it fast. Done. Understood, guys? Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, next question. Look at the next question. We'll go for the next question.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you re-explain this method to once again, sir? I do not understand it.
Nothing is there to look at this here. We also can write it. Two distinct intersecting lines cannot be parallel to the same line. Means what? Two distinct intersecting lines means what? What is the meaning of that? Distinct intersecting line. Look at this here. Yeah, the two lines, one intersecting line. This is one intersecting lines. Cannot be parallel to the same line. Look at this here. These two are lines. And this line, the drawing, the passing line, which cannot be parallel to line one and line two. Get my point? That is the meaning of that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, this cross line is there. This cross line cannot be parallel to this horizontal lines. That is the meaning of that. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Make it fast. How can we write this?
Sir, existence means outside only, right?
Existence of parallel. See, does Euclid's fifth postulate imply the existence of parallel lines? Exist means present.
Okay.
Make it fast, any one of you? See, he is asking, does Euclid's fifth postulate imply the existence of parallel lines? Of course, yes.
If we annex the sum of interior angles, if that is equal to 180 degrees, then the lines won't get won't intersect at any further point.
Yes. So we'll write briefly. Look at this here. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. You can write like this. Yes, it does.
Sir, explain.
Yes, 1 second. Yes, it does. Okay, let me write here. If a straight line, any line, you say L line, falls or passes through L, passes through two lines, let us say yes and T, let us say like this, such that any line you can take, you can give any number, such that sum of the interior angles on one side of the line L is 180 degrees. Or equal to 180 degrees. Okay, less than 180. So this is what? Is two right angles or 180 degrees. One side of L is two right angles. Then by Euclid's fifth postulate, lines M or lines S
and T are parallel to each other.
S and line T are. Are you understanding what I'm writing on the board?
Yes, sir.
Will not meet on the side of line L.
Sir, what if the straight line passes through both the two lines and the angles, both of the side angles are less than 180 degrees?